highly anticipated and masterfully directed performance of The 39 Steps. Before we begin, please take a moment to silence all sound-emitting electronic devices. Yes, I'm talking about you in the blue shirt, third row. Good. And now, without any further ado, please enjoy The 39 Steps.
Thank you. called?
What was Napoleon's horse called? Napoleon's horse was called Bellerophon, when he rode for the final time at Waterloo, June 15th, 1815. Am I right, sir?
Quite right, Mr. Memory!
Thank you!
Thank you! Thank you! Another question. How old may West? How old may West, Mr. Memory?
Well, I know, sir, but I never tell the lady's age.
Very good, Mr. Memory!
Thank you!
Thank you! All right, a serious question, please.
I say.
A question from the balcony.
Over here. How far is Winnipeg from Montreal?
Oh, a gentleman from Canada. You're welcome, sir.
Well then, Mr. Memory, how far is Winnipeg from Montreal?
Winnipeg from Montreal, you say? Winnipeg from Montreal? That's 1,454 miles. Am I right, sir?
Quite right.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Scheiße!
We have another question.
Are you all right?
In the middle?
Thank you, yes!
Calm down, ladies and gents! Calm down, please!
Excuse me!
Yes?
May I come home?
What's the big idea?
Well, I'd like to!
Calm down, please!
Well, it's awful tricky at the moment, and I've got the decorators in, and...
Please! You have to!
Your funeral!
That's enough! Mr. Memory!
I know what's up!
Play, man, play!
Thank you!
That was Mr. Memory!
Thank you!
Don't forget his name now!
Thank you!
Mr. Memory!
Thank you!
Thank you! Thank you.
Never can find the switch, damn it.
Turn it off! Quickly! Shucks! Light! Blind! Pull the blind!
Blind, yes.
Now the light, Mr.
Thank you.
Now, do you believe me?
Ha ha ha! Tell you what, bring him back to me
when they're filled.
Oh.
Get it? When they're filled, don't be shy. Halifax? Durham? Berwick upon Tweed? Biscuit?
Much obliged.
Biscuit?
No, thank you.
Feed yourself. Well, here we are, Edinburgh town.
That was quick.
Wonder what won the 2 o'clock at Windsor.
I'll get a paper.
I'll go to the lavatory.
Oh,
excuse me. Sorry.
Oh,
sorry.
Sorry.
Oh, God.
Sorry.
Run me.
Sorry.
Oh my God. My bad. Sorry.
Oh, sorry. Evening paper.
Sure. Evening paper. Let us know. Evening paper. Let us know. Evening paper, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Evening paper. Let us know.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Sorry to disturb you, but have you seen this man? His name is Richard Manning.
Darling, how lovely to see you.
Sounds like somebody's having a free lunch in there.
I'm so sorry, but I was desperate. I had to do it. My name's Richard Haddock. They're after me for murder. I swear I'm innocent. The safety of the country depends upon me.
Excuse me. Sorry to disturb you. Have either of you seen this man passing in the past few minutes? His name is Richard Annie.
This is the man you want, Inspector.
But we came by just new, and you two were, well, you know.
He pushed me. He enforced himself upon me. His name is Richard Annie.
Is your name Richard Annie?
Certainly not.
Well, this attractive lady.
Right, sir!
Two and six.
see to the coos.
Sorry?
I'll see to the coos.
Right.
My wife!
Well done.
Will you come in? There's your bed.
Marvelous.
Could you sleep there, do you think?
I could sleep anywhere right now.
Won't you sit down, please, whilst we go on with our supper?
Oh, thank you. I say.
Yes?
You wouldn't happen to have today's paper, would you?
My husband has.
Right. So, been in these parts long?
No. I'm from Glasgow.
Glasgow?
Did you ever see it?
No, I never did.
Oh, you should. You should see such the old street on a Saturday night, with all its fine shops and the trams and the lights and the cinema palaces and the crowds.
Montreal, Edinburgh, and
London.
London? All about London, if you like.
Could you?
Certainly could.
John would they approve of that, I doubt.
John?
My husband, he says, best not to think of such places. And all the wickedness that goes on there.
Or I could tell you now.
Now?
What would you like to know?
Is it true that all the ladies paint their toenails?
Some of them.
And put rouge and lipsticks on their faces?
They do, yes.
London ladies are beautiful.
They wouldn't if you were beside them.
You ought not to say that.
I'd not to say what?
nothing at all. I was just telling your wife how I prefer living in the town to the country. That's all.
God made the country.
Certainly did.
Except for what, woman?
Almost.
Then hurry, sir.
Might I have a look at your paper?
Suit yourself. You did nay tell me your name.
Oh, Hammond.
Mr. O'Hum Hammond.
No, just Hammond.
Here we are!
Say a blessing before we begin. Oh, most mighty and unforgiving Father, sanctify these undeserved mercies to us miserable sinners. Make us bow on bended knee, and make us truly thankful for all thy manifold blessings, and continually turn our loathsome hearts from wickedness, and beat our gluttonous thoughts and lash our lustful desires with three-forked flailing stick. And beat our bestial noses to the grindstone, and blind our wicked eye to the tawdry beads and baubles of all worldly wicked things. Amen.
Amen.
Ach, I forgot to lock the barn. I'll go and lock it.
Thank you.
own, making love behind me back. Get out! And as for me.
Not so fast, my friend.
No, go, go, it's your last chance of liberty.
You're all wrong about her. She's only trying to help me.
The big shame upon me, House.
Actually, if you want to know, I'm on the run from the police.
Police?
They're after me for murder.
Murder? Police? Open up. They're right outside.
And tell them I'm not here. I'll make it worth your while.
How much?
£5.
In cash?
What will you take a check?
Don't be funny with me, boy.
Pay him. Oh, I didn't trust him. Listen. I was right. He's double crossing you. Quick, through the window. What that window?
Well, what other window is there?
The rear window.
Thank you.
Jordan. I'm the professor's wife, Louisa Jordan.
Oh. Well, it's nice to meet you, Mrs. Jordan. But I need to see the professor. It's really quite important.
Mike, I know.
Tell him, Mr. Hammond, I'm a friend of Miss Annabella Schmidt.
Of course, Miss Annabella Schmidt. Come in, Miss Hammond.
Lovely home.
We like it. We're just having a few drinks with some friends to celebrate my daughter Louise's birthday. A few well-to-do acquaintances with my husband, the sheriff of the county. Later, we're organizing a shooting party. Join us.
That sounds very nice.
Shall we? On second thoughts, I should like to address my husband directly. If you wouldn't mind waiting here, Mr. Hammond.
Qualities.
War? Oh yes, we will have quite a show of it.
qualities.
But what those are qualities are there?
Well, loyalty, selflessness, sacrifice, love.
Love? When have you ever loved anyone, Kane? It's not in your nature, old sport.
Never has been, has it?
You have no heart.
But you know, sis.
So sad, isn't it? No one to love, no one to care for, no one to go to. But there is, you see. There is. Our home.
Our home?
That is the only place you will ever find love, Kane. Where you really and truly. Oh, we will give you love, Kane. And in return, you will love us. See Master Ace on our great unstoppable march, commanded eternally by destiny itself. Well, Oldsport, what do you say? Will you join us, Kane?
Well, Professor, if you think I'm suitable material.
Oh, I do. I do, Oldsport. How unutterly splendid. I will tell Mrs. Curry.
Wait, Professor.
Yes?
There's just one thing.
Of course, yes.
Before I sign up.
Just give me
one little question.
Absolutely, my liebling.
What are the 39 steps?
The 39 steps, so I saved myself, is mine own brilliant idea. The very soul of the enterprise. The very... But wait a minute. Wait a minute. You!
Me?
You can fool the fools. You think you can come in here, and then...
No, Master Race, I despise you.
You are as bad as she was. And I feel like he's all around the sentimental notions. High-minded, can democratic-ish, falling scheisse drivel. I thought for a moment you might. But no! No! You pathetic, pusillanimous, petty-minded!
Are you wishing to see me, Sheriff?
Yes, Inspector. You think I like playing for time?
time with the murderer?
Murderer!
You are under arrest for the murder of an unknown woman in Portland Mansions, London, Tuesday last. Inspector, take him to county jail.
But you heard my story. It's true. Every word of it.
We're not such imbeciles. It's not ninners. I think. I don't believe your cock and bull story about the professor. Why, he's my best friend in the district.
What if the professor didn't shoot me? Then where'd that bullet come from?
Grab him, man! Get me Professor Jordan. Annie, you're in deep water, and it's getting deeper by the second. This is the sheriff of the county, and I'll have you know that. Professor? Yes, Professor. Everything's under control, sir. Yes, sir. We have apprehended the villain, sir. Yes, everything's under control, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I demand to speak to the Foreign Office in London.
Foreign Office in London. Yes. Handcuffs, Inspector, please.
Come along quietly, sir. Please, sir.
Handcuffs going on now, sir.
I don't think so.
He's escaping! Stop him! Stop that man!
Thank you.
Settle down now, please. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I must apologize for my hesitation in addressing you. But to tell you the simple truth, I entirely failed to realize that the chairman's flattering description just now was about me. Thank you. Thank you very much. Anyway, when I had journeyed up to Scotland a few days ago, traveling along the Highland Express with a magnificent structure, the Fourth Bridge, I entirely failed to realize that I should be addressing an important political meeting. But may I say from the bottom of my heart, in the utmost sincerity, how delighted and relieved I am to find myself in your presence at this moment. Oh, hello, do take a seat. Oh, good heavens! Hello. Now, where was I? Delighted! Not to say relieved. For so long as I stand on this platform, I'm delivered from the cares and anxieties that are always the lot of a man in my position. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're here tonight to discuss... Well, what shall we discuss? I know, about the herring tree, or haddock, perhaps, or the idle rich. Not that I can talk about that, because I'm not rich and I've certainly never been idle. Thank you. Anyway, I've been pretty busy all my life, really. Well, not that recently. Recently, the last few days, really. Everything's gone a bit haywire, so. Well, not that recently. The last day, really. I wouldn't say it's been easy. Pretty damn difficult, actually. But the odd thing is, you carry on. And it's pretty bracing when you do. Pulls a chap out of himself, you know what I mean? There he is, no idea what's happening, who to trust, where to turn, whether it'll be worth it at the end of it all. But something, I don't know, stirs the old bones, gets the ticker pumping again, and there's no time to think, and your mind's singing, and your heart's racing, and you're meeting people, real people, doing the best they can. Yes, doing the best they can in all the troubles the world throws at them. Suffering things, no man or woman ought to suffer. And I'll tell you what else they do. They do the best they can for other people too. Whatever problems they've got, they damn well keep going. Is that such an outmoded sentimental notion? Is it? Well, is it? So look here. Let's all just set ourselves resolutely to make this a good world, a better world, a world where no nation plots against nation, where no neighbor plots against neighbor, where suspicion and cruelty have been forever banished, where there's no persecution or hunting down. So I'm asking you, each and every one of you here tonight, you, and you, and you, and you, and you, and definitely you! Is that the sort of world you want? Because that's the sort of world I want! So come on, let's vote on it! Vote for a good world! A better world! And above all, vote for Mr. McCrocodile!
Well, if it's absolutely necessary,
Thank you for your help, miss. If you'd like to step into the car, please, miss.
The what?
Ha 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 ha!
if I go.
I say, what is the use of all this? Ow! And do stop doing that. Those policemen will get you.
They're not policemen.
Oh, really? So when did you find that out?
You found that out yourself. I would never have known that was the wrong road to Inverary if it wasn't for you. They were taking us to their boss with the little finger missing. God help either of us if we need them.
So you're still sticking to your penny novelette spy story?
All right, then you're alone on a desolate moor, manacled to a plainly common murderer who stabbed an innocent, defenseless woman less than 4 days ago. If that's the situation you'd prefer, then have it, my dear, and welcome.
I'm not afraid of you.
Bless you.
Sandwiches, scotch and soda, and a glass.
glass of milk.
Of course, of course. Ah, the young doves. If you wouldn't mind following me to your room now, please. And there we are, all ready, Phoebe. A fine roaring fire. Now, dearie, off with that wet scout of yours and all of it dried in the kitchen.
No, don't worry. It'll dry by the fire just as well. Thanks all the same.
No doubt the gentleman will take good care of you. Good night, sir. Good night, madam.
Look, if you think that I'm going to spend the whole night with you in this room, in that...
Well, what else are you going to do?
Let me go!
Come in.
Oh, excuse me.
It's quite all right. We were just getting warm by the fire.
I can see that.
You do surprise me.
You know, when I first took a life to crime, I was quite squeamish about it. sensitive child. But soon I got hardened. I was an in-and-out villain, wanted on 3 continents. Just think that in years to come, you'll be able to go to Madame Tussauds and point me out.
Exactly.
Inveterate, irreformable no-holders, wedded to a life of crime. That's me, Pamela, my darling, and the sad story of my life. Poor little orphan boy who never had a chance. Irredeemable, irreclaimable. Ugh. Utterly horrid and beastly. I'd get away from me as quick as I could if I was you. Oh, wait. You can.
Mrs. Jordan, please listen. We had to take the girl as well. Unfortunately not. We lost both her and Hannah, I'm afraid. Well, look, by now. She'll know we're not the real police.
Thank you.
Morning!
What's the big idea? How'd you get out of this? Why didn't you run away?
I did. Then, just as I was going, I discovered you'd been speaking the truth, so I thought I'd stay.
Yes, what earthquake caused your brain to work at last?
Two policemen came here last night. The ones from the car. I overheard them telephoning. They're not policemen!
Well, why didn't you stop them?
Sorry.
Never mind that. Keep going. What did they say?
Oh, they talked about a lot of stuff. Something with a number. 20, 30, 30!
9!
39, that's right!
Steps?
39 steps! How did you know that? Someone's going to warn them.
What?
How can you warn steps?
Never mind that. Keep going.
Yes. Someone's got the wind up and is clearing out, and I know they're picking up someone from the London Palladium.
The London Palladium! The London Palladium! Who's that, I wonder? Is that the professor? Our friend with the little finger missing? Awfully funny thing for a master spy to do.
I'm sorry. I feel such an awful fool for not having believed you.
That's all right. Well, we ought to be.
Yes?
Going, I suppose. Right,
What?
With whom are they staying?
Who?
Those two men. The two men you overheard last night.
Staying there? Well, they're not.
Sorry?
They drove off last night. Rather fast, actually.
Where?
Where? Don't you know. So, does it matter?
Doesn't matter!
What?
What do you mean doesn't matter?
I'm sorry,
you fine-headed idiot, why didn't you stop them?
What?
This is unbelievably appalling!
Button-headed!
Oh my god.
I'm so sorry!
Why didn't you stop them, for God's sake?
Because I wanted to see you!
Well, that was a stupid idea, wasn't it?
Where did they get?
So where'd they go?
I don't know, the London Palladium, I suppose.
The London Palladium? The London Palladium when?
Tonight, on the way out!
On the way out of what?
I don't know, Fork!
Well, thanks very much, that's 4 or 5 precious hours wasted.
Well, they're all in the country, that's fine, isn't it? Just leave well alone!
Leave well alone! I'm accused of murder, and the only way to clear my name is to expose these spies.
There you go again, you see? Selfish!
What?
Utterly horrid, beastly, and selfish!
But much more important than that. Much more important than clearing my name. They've got a secret, vital to the safety of our air defense, and it could put the whole country at jeopardy.
Well, I'm very, very sorry!
Monday or evening?
I don't know!
Well, thanks very much for your help. Goodbye!
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 And don't expect me to come with you!
I won't!
Good!
Good!
I'm not surprised you weren't born then!
This is the London Palladium.
Wait, David, I have to go. the professor's here. You see the professor? I see the professor. Good heavens! I thought you'd run off.
You ran off.
Well, I was bloody furious.
I'll go then, shall I?
No, no, don't. You're already here.
All right.
But look, I found him.
Who?
The professor.
The professor? Where?
There, there.
Never in all eternity! Sorry!
What just happened?
I don't have a
the country too.
Irredeemable. Irreclaimable. Utterly horrid and beastly.
Poor little orphan boy who never had a chance.